We're the Whitty family, and we have a 5-year-old daughter who has Down syndrome. Her name is Olivia.
Keep going, Libby Lou, look up.
Some of the health issues that come along with children that have Down syndrome are heart defects that oftentimes require surgery.
Go, Libby, go. Go, Libby, go.
They're generally weaker. They need to work a little harder to move their muscles, or another word for that is hypotonia. There can be problems with vision. Children with Down syndrome are at higher risk for leukemia as well.
I would like to see the researchers that are focusing on Down syndrome find ways that potentially could keep individuals with Down syndrome out of the hospital due to medical challenges that they face.
We all know people with Down syndrome, and we all know that there is a lot that goes right in their brain development. And so we are not looking for a cure, we're really looking for how to improve their quality of life so that they can be more engaged in society. In Down syndrome, the research questions that we have are very fundamental, basic questions about how the development of the brain is different in individuals with Down syndrome. Human embryonic stem cells, the cells that were isolated by Jamie Thompson here on campus, are the true stem cells, those that reside in the embryo and give rise to all the cell types of the body. In the 10 years after Jamie first isolated those cells, people spend a lot of time trying to figure out what is it that makes a stem cell so special, and can we make stem cells from other cell types? 2007 and 2008, Jamie and Shinya Yamanaka figured out a way to reprogram other cells to behave like human embryonic pluripotent stem cells. And these are called induced pluripotent stem cells because we take other cell types like skin or blood and induce them to become human stem cells. And then they have the characteristics of pluripotent stem cells, can be turned into any cell type of the body, and provide a very valuable way to study disease, for example, because we can use skin cells from people with a specific disease, reprogram them to induce pluripotent stem cells, and then turn them into the cell type that is affected in the disease that's affecting that patient. And the cells will retain that genetic mutation that causes the disease. And so this is the true value of induced pluripotent stem cells. First, they avoid some of the ethical concerns that are inherent in using embryonic stem cells. And second, they can be generated from people with different diseases as a way to study those diseases. And so what we can do is we take our iPS cells and turn them into brain cells and watch each step in brain development in the dish. These are the Down syndrome iPS cells, and they really don't look any different. And that makes sense because people with Down syndrome, most of their body is normal. So for example, individuals with Down syndrome have fewer nerve cells in certain parts of their brain. And so what we are trying to do in using our iPS cells in the dish is try and recapitulate what happens to result in fewer brain cells. And so if we can identify what mistakes are made, we can potentially figure out how to change that. The people in our research group share two common research goals. The first is to better understand human brain development by using these stem cells. And the second is to do disease modeling to help understand specific neurodevelopmental disorders and neurodegenerative disorders. The Waisman Center is a remarkable place to work because in addition to human stem cell work, we have a clinic that services families who have developmental disorders. We have a preschool where up to a third of the kids have a disability. And then we have many labs focused on behavioral research of individuals with disabilities and typically developing individuals to better understand how kids learn to talk, kids learn to hear, and the more day-to-day life skills that are pretty far removed from the kind of research that we do. And so it's really a unique and very engaging and very satisfying place to work, because not only do we get to answer our research questions, but we see the big picture. We get to see people and families who have these developmental disorders. And that really puts a human perspective on the kind of basic research that we do. At the Waisman Center, it is a particularly happy place to work because so many people who work here and so many people who visit the Waisman Center are touched by developmental disorders. And many people who work here have siblings with developmental disorders. So there really is a connection between the research and the families here at Waisman.
Ready? To have so much research and new knowledge being acquired so close to that preschool helps us, you know, feel better about where our daughter's starting her education.
I haven't thought a lot about a cure for Downs, and I think I don't think about that much because I don't believe that it's important and I don't believe that it's necessary. And I say that because Olivia is our daughter and we love her, and we love her because of who she is, and part of who she is she has Down syndrome. And to think that Olivia would be in our family and wouldn't have Down syndrome would change her whole life, would change it not for the better, but for the worse, because we love her for who she is. We love her for what she's brought to our family.
Olivia Lou, are you gonna color the rest of the seat?
When the researchers are really trying to improve the life of an individual, I think that they need to look at how are they improving the life of an individual but maintaining that person's identity, and that person's identity and who they are is having Down syndrome. And if they can enhance their life by taking away the heart surgeries or the brain surgeries or other things, that would be a wonderful thing.
Good job, Livy Lou. Thanks for sharing. Okay. You color on this one so that I can...